Syria is undergoing a mass migration due to war. Internal conflicts and unrest amongst different ideological groups are causing many to flee to neighboring countries. These Arabic countries are unable to hold such high numbers of refugees, causing many to now seek asylum in Europe and Canada.
The Syrian crisis is not an isolated crisis. It's part of changes that are taking place in the Middle East, in North Africa. The area, it keep on change according to different situations. Changes started in the 60s and then 70s, 80s. So it started with some countries, adjacent countries, and 5-6 years ago, the Arab Spring started in countries in North Africa. It was exported to other countries like Syria. It started like a small crisis, and it became, you know, gradually, year by year, it grew up and became a real humanitarian crisis in that country.
It's safe here. That's the number one thing that we care about. You know, we came from not a very safe place, so we care about safety.
Mara came to Canada from Aleppo, Syria. These pictures show the aftermath of a shell going off at her house.
Oh, I freaked out.
Excited?
Excited and scared too. Yeah, I was scared because I came here alone. My family is back in Aleppo. I was preparing for it for many months. I was ready, you know, mentally ready. But I freaked out at first, yes. Applying was very easy. Not much forms, not much applications. But actually finding a sponsor was the problem. I went to the church in Aleppo and I asked for Father Jack's number. And I talked to him, and there is a lot of things that I don't want to say. He sponsored me eventually, and I came here, but the process is not that hard. It's easy. I got out of Aleppo on November 2015. I went to Lebanon and stayed there for more than a month. And then my papers were ready, and I came here. I saw piles of snow, you know, somewhere. Just, I expected snow, but not that much snow. You know? I'm at work all day, so I just come from work to my home, and from my home to my work. It's kind of frustrating. I mean, I have a master's degree in demography and economics. So I'm working as a cashier in Adonis, and yeah, they told me it's good as a start, but yeah, it's really frustrating. Just want to say thank you for the opportunity. I mean, America didn't open its arms, its heart, so Canada did. They really saved our lives. Without Canada, I would just be back home, just scared under missiles and not safe with no future. Yeah, that was very hard, so I'm pretty grateful.
However, not everyone has the same experience as Mara. Some are supported by the government and not privately sponsored. At the Toronto Plaza Hotel, Fazi and Sana Al Hamad are getting accustomed with life here in Canada.
والله في من النوم ننزل لتحت نفطر هاي هي ما في شيء انه معين نعمله يعني قبل الحرب كثير اوقاتنا بالعكس نقضيها كثير حلوه يعني ما عندنا طبيعه حلوه وعندنا شغلات كثير يعني انا عندي قرايبي كلهم حوالي بزور قرايبي بزوروني هيك بنقضيها والله هلا بعدنا بالاوتيل لا شفنا منيح ولا شفنا قبيح يعني ما بنعرف شيء لسه بالأوتيل بس على انه ما شفنا عالم كثير منيحه يعني ما بعرف لسه. بالأيام الحرب يعني ما في هالهاي، صار انقلب بالعكس، يعني ما عاد في تواصل، ما عاد في مثل أول. يعني رحلة حلوة بالعكس، خاصة بالطيارة الكندية كتير كانت كويسة كتير، يعني ما حسينا بالتعب أبدا. إنه كتير معنا مناح الكنديين، أول ما طلعنا بالطيارة كتير مناح كانوا معنا، حسينا إنه رايحين على مكان أمان، على مكان ناس بيعرفوا الإنسانية، يعني ناس بيحبوا يعملوا خير للعالم، يعني للإنسان المثلهم. نقول لهم نشكرهم على ترحيبهم وعلى اهتمامهم، ويعني كتير حبيناهم، يعني لسه ما شفنا حدا بس من طريقة الترحيب حبيناهم.
مو بل احنا عندنا ارض زراعيه نشتغل فيها، حياتنا هيك، نزرعها على البيت،
وعندنا محل البسه جاهزه بالبيت بشتغل فيها
بالمحل، يعني
محل
البسه
جاهزه، يعني محل خاص لنا، يعني
كان واجتماعيين مع العالم شو،
لانه لما سوونا المقابلات هناك احنا قبل ما نعرف عن كندا كل شيء، نعرف اسم دوله كندا وبس. لما حشونا بالمقابلات وشيء انه الوضع يختلف، لما جينا هين تغير علينا الوضع.
احنا كنا ساكنين بمخيم بيروت، قلنا احنا بنطلع من المخيم بالخيم، مخيمات هاي، قلنا من المخيم نجي على دولة، يعني صرنا 3 سنين عشنا في، تعرف انت اسوأ الحالات، بدنا نجي لهون، احنا بدنا نجي، بدنا نكون احنا ننسى كل شيء الماضي اللي عشناه. يعني هلا اجينا معلش احنا 4 اشخاص، يعني
صارنا شهرين
والدولة عم تعطينا 1500 دولار، واخذنا بيت ب 1400 دولار، كيف بدنا نعيش؟ تفاجئنا بالحكي هذا، 1400، يعني تفاجئنا بالمعيشة، كيف يعني هيك ما، يعني كيف الحل؟ وعمل ما في، بدنا نتعلم الدراسة أول شيء، ما فيك تشتغل هلا، صح إنه نص بدك تشتغل نص الراتب، بس إنه بدنا نتعلم لغة، إذا ما تعلم لغة ما فينا، يعني بدنا اليوم أشتغل مع أي شخص، إذا ما يكون هو لي ضمان ما فيني أشتغل، يا يكون عندي معي لغة، واللغة هي السلاح الأساسي هون بدكم، يعني غالي كتير، ما مثل ما حكونا هناك، يعني يعني بعد ما نروح على البيت بدنا اول شيء نتعلم. هلا ما فينا، ما تعلم لغه كيف بدك تخلص حالك، بدك تروح على المحل، بدك تمشي بالشارع، ما في، يعني اذا ما تعرف لغه كيف، يعني انت مثل ضايع. بعدنا نحن صارنا شهرين
ما تعلمنا،
نحن اجينا هدف اول شيء معلش، صارنا اولادنا مثل كنا بلبنان 3 سنين ما دخلوا المدارس، ندخل المدرسه، انا صارنا شهرين لا انا تعلمت لا زوجتي لا اولادي ما دخلوا المدرسه، عم ياخذوا المدرسه صح هون بس مدرسه ترفيهيه بس هيك. نحن جينا مشان نتعلم، هلا بعدنا ما نروح على البيت، عم بيقولوا هذا بعد ما تروح على البيت، كله هذا بعد البيت، يعني بعد البيت امتى؟ بعد ما تخلص سنه، كل ما هي سنه.
وقت عرفت انكم جايين كندا؟
والله كيف،
والله شعورنا فرح، يعني الصراحه انا كشعوري لا يوصف، انبسطنا وحكينا مع العالم، قالوا قال بده اصح له على كندا، يعني شيء هاي من الخيال. اول شيء نهني الشعب الكندي والحكومه الكنديه والصحافة وجوستو تورتو، هو إجى على بيروت وشاف المخيمات وطلب كل اللاجئين، يعني ما بي رئيس وزراء عمل هالشيء غيره. يعني
local efforts have been very successful, I think, in terms of the outreach from the community. On the other hand, and you'll see this especially with housing, I think there's also going to be a stress on the system overall, and there are going to be some growing pains to it. And I think that will be the next phase of all of this, is once there's the work of getting people prepared to welcome refugees, is making sure that we're providing proper support, shelter, and care for refugees on an ongoing basis.
Especially refugees and newcomers, when they arrive in Canada, one, they're inundated with change. Number two is they're on a limited income. Many of them need to find their survival jobs. They need to be able to put food on the table, a roof over their families' heads, and to kind of reestablish themselves in the community, reestablish their lives based on where they were coming from. Given the fact that clothing becomes a very expensive aspect of life, when you're looking at winter coats, boots, seasonal wear, that in some countries they may never need it because they're from warm climate countries. For us to be able to provide that gently used clothing really frees up a lot of their money and resources to be able to apply to other areas. We are basically contributing to helping them sustain themselves while they rebuild their lives.
The medical committee, our main focus is just to kind of focus on the people that are falling through the cracks. There is Access Alliance at the hotel here that does a lot of medical problems, and they arrange all the appointments for the doctors. for all of the people that need to see a doctor. So our main goal was to bring in all the volunteers. We have a huge list of volunteers that wanted to help out. And these volunteers generally take them to appointments and kind of just translate to them if there's little problems. We created workshops for a lot of the refugees about the healthcare in Canada, where to go if they're sick, how to access the hospital and other resources in the community. And we're trying to focus a lot on the mental health. A lot of them are coming with trauma, and so kind of just giving them the resources that are in the communities and making sure that they're being seen.
The success we can manage is not with the old people, they are coming here, but with their children who will be building their future and can be fruitful and productive in this country.
Hello.
Beautiful.
نحن حبيناهم كثير الكنديين وهم كثير منيحين معنا.
كيف حابين حياتهم؟
منيحة. حلوة.
في أي شيء تحبين
منيحة؟ بنقول لهم شكرا لتعاملهم معنا منيح.